Hello again, we are now going to go ahead and solve another static equilibrium. This is going to be problem. This is going to be a static equilibrium problem number two. So what we have in this problem is an inclined plane of inclination theta and an object on this inclined plane that is in static equilibrium. There is an applied force horizontal FA in purple over here that will keep this object at rest on the ramp. The other forces acting upon the object are the force of gravity, like always vertically downwards in black here, mg. The static force of friction, this object would tend to move downwards, so the static force of friction is going to be in the opposite direction of the tendency to move. And the normal force, which is perpendicular to the surface. In order to make sure that this object is in static equilibrium, we need to resolve couple of forces over here and then check the magnitudes in such a way that all magnitudes show us a balance of forces. So for that, we are going to look at, first of all, the applied force, and that's going to be resolved into the x and y components. By the way, we already have the x-axis here. The y-axis is the one that's perpendicular to it. So when I resolve FA, I'm going to have one force this direction, and another force overlapping my static force of friction a bit longer. Now those two forces will be the components of FA, and how are we going to know what they are in terms of labeling? Well, this angle over here, theta, is going to be equal to this angle over here. So therefore, this force, the one that goes along the horizontal, being the adjacent to the angle theta, will be FA cosine theta. The one that's along the x-axis, the y-axis over here, being the, again, this is theta here, being the same as this over here, must be my FA sine theta. Now we are going to also resolve mg like we always did in the past with inclined plane problems. And when we do that, we get one component over here and another component over here. We know that this angle theta here is the same as this angle theta here, which is the same as that angle theta there. So therefore, this component must be mg sine theta, and this component must be mg cosine theta. So now we have all forces going in only two directions. On the x, we have mg sine theta, and in the opposite direction, we have Fs, this little green force over here, let's not lose it, and Fa cosine theta. And on the y, we have the normal force in blue, and Fa sine theta and mg cosine theta going in the opposite direction. Let's do a magnitude check very fast. Mg sine theta over here is going to be 5 centimeters, which has to be the same as when I add up Fs and Fa cosine theta magnitudes. So Fs is 1.5, Fa cosine theta is 3.5. So we're good, 3.5 plus 1.5 is exactly Mg sine theta, which is 5. On the y, we need to have this long normal force, which is 9, equal in magnitude to the sum of mg cosine theta, which is 5.5, and fa sine theta, which is 1.5. So 5.5 plus 1.5 gives me 7, so the normal force is too long. We are going to shorten it by 2 centimeters to make sure that it's only 7 centimeters in length. There we go. The new normal force will only be this long to balance out the forces going in the opposite direction. So now we have the magnitude check done. Let's pick our positive directions, upward here and down the ramp here. The givens are mg, theta, and mu s, and we need to determine the magnitude of the applied force. So let's go ahead and remember that this object is in static equilibrium, which means both F net X and F net Y must be equal to zero. Let's start with the X forces. We have one going down the ramp, positive direction, and 2 going up the ramp. So a vector sum of 3 forces, 1 and 2 and 3, should be equal to 0. So the positive 1 is mg sine theta, positive mg sine theta. And in the opposite direction, we have negative fs and negative fa cosine theta. When we simplify this, we are going to end up having the following scalar equation. Positive mg sine theta just becomes mg sine theta, and then negative fs, and then negative fa cosine theta equals 0, but we know that fs is mu s times n, so when we plug that in there, we get mg sine theta minus mu s n minus, let's make this n a little bit bigger, minus fa cosine theta equals 0. Let's move on to the f net y equation. We have 1 and 2 and 3 forces. Their vector sum must be equal to 0. So 1 and 2 and 3 forces added up to give me 0. Well, let's see what their directions and magnitudes are. We have the positive n, and then we have negative fa sine theta. And then we have negative mg cosine theta. When we simplify this, we end up having n minus fa sine theta minus mg cosine theta equals 0. We solve for n, so we can plug it in there. N is going to be equal to fa sine theta minus mg cosine theta, because we move both of them, actually plus, we move both of them to the other side to isolate n, both of them being negative, when they are moved to the other side, they become positive. And now we are ready to take this normal force from here, plug it in there, and see what our new equation will look like. So the new equation, when we combine these two, will be mg sine theta minus mu s times n, so open parenthesis, fa sine theta plus mg cosine theta, close parenthesis, and then minus fa cosine theta equals 0. Remember, our TBD is fa, so then we are going to have to distribute mu s here, because fa is inside the parenthesis. So mg sine theta, when we distribute negative mu s, we have negative mu s fa sine theta, negative mu s mg cosine theta, negative fa cosine theta equals 0. Now we look at all these four terms and we see that our TBD is in these two terms, so we are going to factor it out. We keep the first term, we factor out negative fa from these two, so then what we have left from this part, we already factored out the negative, we have a mu s sine theta, and from this one, we already factored out the negative, we have a positive cosine theta, and we still have this term that we didn't yet write down, so we are going to write it down right now, minus mu s mg cosine theta, that equals 0, and now we are going to move this entire term to the other side, which makes it positive, and then solve for fa. So mg sine theta minus mu s mg cosine theta, so these two terms stay here, but this one moves to the other side, becomes positive, fa, positive now, right? Since it's negative here, when moved to the other side, it becomes positive. Open parenthesis, mu s sine theta plus cosine theta. Close parenthesis and solve for fa. Fraction bar, this whole expression in the top. I'm going to factor out an mg to make it look nicer. We have a sine theta minus mu s cosine theta inside the parentheses now, once we factored out the mg, and in the bottom, obviously this entire expression, mu s sine theta plus cosine theta, circle, and that is our answer in terms of the givens, theta, mu s, m, and g. Theta, mu s, m, and g. And that is all. Thank you.